What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to episode 4 of our realistic rebuilding the Orlando Magic. This has been going pretty good, actually. You guys have been starting to enjoy it. I've been getting a lot of views between these past couple of videos, so I definitely can't complain. Excuse me. If you can see here, I actually had to jump in and battle this game. This was a, I think, double overtime game. 151 to 140. It was pretty insane, not gonna lie. Anyways, I did make a little bit of advancements from the last game. As you can see, our record, or from the last episode, our record is 23-19, so we are positive. We got to the fourth seed. This is great. What I did was I just kind of simmed some games. I was going to sim to the All-Star break, but, you know, I decided to wait, kind of hold it off. I want you guys to be able to enjoy this a little bit more, so we did do that. We held off a little bit. Actually won a bunch of games up until then, and everybody looks to be doing pretty great right now. The roster's looking nice. Unfortunately, Vucevic is still out for a while here, but you look at the numbers. He's averaging 16, Fournier is averaging 13, Joakim Noah's doing his thing. Actually, he's averaging a double-double. There is a little issue. Vooch, poor guy. There is a little issue that I see coming through. Seems like the team status. We have a ton of players who are having some issues right now. He wants more playing time. Some other people want more playing time. Some people want lower training intensity, things like that. You just can't possibly give that to everybody. I can look at the coaching game plan and see. He could lose a few minutes here. And we'll give those couple of minutes to Laverne. Yeah. But Doug McDermott is getting 13 minutes a game. He is small forward. There's not really a lot that we can, you know, spread. We're running a fairly small lineup. But I'm trying to figure out what we can do. I mean, we could take away Quincy Acey's minutes, but he's been doing pretty well, so, excuse me, sorry. I don't necessarily want to do that. Also, if you guys want to be so kind as to look at this, like I said, we're 4th seed. Brooklyn is 12th seed. Wait, 12th. No, 13th, sorry. We traded our first round picks. We swapped them. So they have our 4th seed first round pick for this year. We have their 13th seed. That's great. That's going to get us a high pick, and I think it was a super duper good investment. Now, we're going to try and get some games through here. We've got Memphis coming in. We're going to simulate. Actually, we'll sim games since we just got the loss. Sim regular old game. Let's see what we get. I don't know if we're going to win this. This is a good defensive team, and we lost. We lost by 6 points. Evan Fournier dropped in 26. Aaron Gordon got the double-double. Oladipo didn't actually shoot the ball that much. We're going to go ahead and sim this game. Well, now we've lost 3 straight, so we're kind of slipping. He came back, although Laverne doing great work. Yeah, we've lost 3 straight games. Not good. We don't want to be doing this, especially coming off a pretty nice win streak. I like this. And now we lost 4. Yeah, right here we went, I think, 6 straight games, and now we've lost 4 straight games, so starting to even out a little bit. Oladipo's still continuing to be positive. We're going to sim game here. He wants to increase the training intensity. I can do that. I can't. Probably a good idea, knowing as I keep going back and forth from really low and to really high. So that helped. Let's go to training. What I really would like to do, though, is keep it so these guys get tired, but then give them a super nice rest in between. And that probably would help. So we're actually on high right now. We'll go very high. Yeah, so we're not gonna rest before a back-to-back. And then player training individually. Physical. This should be enough for him. I really, really hope that he doesn't complain about that. So we're trying to finally win the game here. I'd be pretty upset if we couldn't, because personally, it means, you know, there's a lot of stuff that we have to try and do. The online petition, wow, okay. I don't know what's gonna be good. The fan interest went up. I really don't care about the reporter. I think, oh, well, we lost. Not good. Not good at all. We just broke even again. We're down the 7th seed. We're going to simulate with Simcast because we need to do something. Doug McDermott is very, very mad. Did I promise him minutes? We might have to trade him, to be honest. I don't want to, but he's mad. He's very, very mad. No, I gave you extremely high intensity. That was awful. I literally don't know what to say. Doug McDermott. Victor Oladipo. I'm gonna give you very high. I mean, I'm sorry, but, you know, it's a whole mess up. So, we win the first quarter, win the second quarter, we slightly fall third, but we win the fourth, and it all looks good up in here. We're coming back. This is a very, very hard stretch right before the All-Star game. I don't think anybody's going to the All-Star. Actually, MVP. Okay, Rookie of the Year. Obviously, it's not going to be one of us. He is doing very good. Carl Anthony Towns a little less than average, or than his actual stats. We have Joakim Noah as Defensive Player of the Year, fifth spot for that. How did Kevin Love end up over here? We're going to go and actually check that out, because I wanted it to be legit, and, I mean, we'll see what happens. So the magic. Cavaliers have traded Kevin Love for Thaddeus. It might happen. They might have felt like Kevin Love was losing his worth and they needed some guys who could score and maybe tried something. Hornets re-signed Courtney Lee. Pelicans re-signed. Okay. Pistons trade Reggie Bullock and Jody Meeks to shove them. Okay. Not too big. We did this trade. Thunder. Okay, this is kind of a cool trade. This is kind of real. This was not a good deal for Kevin Durant. Not a good deal at all. He's not going to be a free agent. Sorry, guys. We're not going to pick him up. Darn it. This, I don't know about this. It looks like they're going through an entire kind of rebuild in, you know, the Nets. You look here. Actually, yeah. We have their pick, so I hope they don't just start busting out of nowhere. They have gone up a spot. Not good. Not good at all. So we're going to sim through the majority of these games, sim through date, trying to at least win one or two of them. Of course, something's got to come up. Doug McDermott is freezing cold. He's not happy. You know what? You're gonna get a few more minutes. You're gonna get a few more minutes. Okay, so we won that game by 20 points. So that's looking good. Of course, more stuff has to pop up. Why would it ever not? The deadline for trading players is approaching. Yeah, we're gonna have to make some. We're gonna have to make some choices here pretty soon. We lost that by 3. Not so good. I'm trying to stay above, or at least 500. Aaron Gordon for Devin Booker. No, thank you. Not even a little bit. So we got that win. We lost. We're trying to win this. We did win. Well, no. Hold on. What was that? I don't even know what that was. I don't know what that trade offer was, but thank goodness I didn't take it. Everybody's looking happy right now, for the most part. You know, seems to be good. We're winning games. We're looking positive. Laverne, 31 points off the bench. Jeez, this guy's starting to look kind of good. Laverne, 13. Okay, we might have to keep him around for a little while. I kind of like this guy. Yeah, he's staying consistent here. I can't say enough. Has he earned a starting spot? No, not really. Not yet, anyways. He is a center. But, you know, between him and Joakim Noah, we've got a lot of depth at that number one, or the number five spot, excuse me. The all-stars for this, we're looking at East. We have nobody. Anybody new that came in? Actually, we're going to check right now. The conference. Brooklyn went back down. Good. They are really starting to flail a little bit, and that's good for us. Our pick is still worth something. We're gonna send their date here. We're up by two, or yeah, we're up to Kelly Oubre and Gary Neal for Vic Oladipo. That's never gonna happen, not in a million years. Doug McDermott. We're gonna ignore him. What we have to do now is trade him. We have to trade him. I've increased the intensity as much as I could. And just rotations. Oh, they're exhausted. I don't understand what else you want from me. Okay, I can do that. Training, we're gonna very much so lower the intensity. You guys do not need to be dealing with that. Team training. Medium. Yes. And then I think altogether we're gonna have to trade our pal right here of Doug McDermott. Sorry to say, but he's kind of shaping out not to be so positive here. We're not looking for much, but we are looking for some solid offers. Mario Chalmers wouldn't be so bad, actually. Atlanta Hawks gave us Thabo Sofolosha. That's not a bad pick either. Although, Kirk Heinrich, I like him, but I don't think they would actually do. Maybe they would do that. Marco Bellinelli, I love that trade. Although that's a very, very expensive trade. I don't know if I want to do that necessarily. Also, we would have to give away our first pick. Lou Will, off the bench. Dwight Powell and David Lee. This is not bad. This gives us two power forwards. It's less money than Doug McDermott combined. I kind of like that. Unless there's something really big here. There's not. So I think we're going to take it. It's not super duper amazing, but it gives us a little bit of freedom here. And oops. Okay, Doug McDermott's out of the picture. Didn't want to have to do it, but we're trying to keep our chemistry high, and he's bringing it down. Everybody's pretty exhausted. These two guys are... Tyler Zerli wasn't even playing. I don't get it. Maybe I never will. David Lee is a offensive ability. Like, he can do things offensively. We might be en route, actually. A lot of these guys are tired. I want to give some minutes away here. Laverne, I'm going to give that to him. He's been playing well, but, you know, it's make sure he's not over freaking out. Trading away Doug McDermott seems like a bad move. No, fans should not be worried. Not at all. This is very good for us. Very good. We needed this. Chemistry's it's okay. We're gonna try and make it through a lot of this. Does not look too happy, to be honest, right now. Looks like the team is suffering a little bit. No, we're gonna continue simulation. I just don't want to trade anybody else. Oh, we've made a ton of trades this season, and not necessarily the right ones. Laverne, he's starting to play very, very well. We're gonna sim through a lot of this. Oh, more stuff. And people are starting to get upset at the same time. Continue simulation. We don't need that. Oladipo is not going to get traded. I'm not going to trade him. Less fatigue. I guess that's fine. We got blown out by the 76ers again. I don't know what happened. Really don't. Dwight Powell would like. We're gonna ignore that for now. I don't really care about it. It doesn't need to be a part of. You know, we need to fix the guys that actually matter right about now. He's not mad anymore, I guess. Okay. Let's see how our team is doing. Oladipo is our leading scorer, Vucevic second. Okay. I really don't mind this, to be honest. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 players in double digits. That's good. There's nothing wrong with that. We're gonna sim. It looks like we're still up, so we're gonna sim through a couple. Again, we lose to the 76ers. Just not a team we're beating. But we're coming up to playoffs soon, and I'd really like to. Bump us up here and make sure we stay in the playoff picture as much as we can. It's not hard, our press obviously doesn't like us, but my main consideration right now is I need to make this team as happy with me as possible, because worst thing ever is if I got kicked out of the team. Like, they fired me. If they fire me, what am I gonna do? No. The owner has 100 trust. Okay. We're good. We are not going anywhere. Oh, but we will fail in the Hezonja market here. He's not getting 24 minutes a game, probably. Unless he's at like 23.2, then, you know, I'll give him 40 minutes a game. We'll adjust rotations here. Joakim Noah. He's going to come off the bench for now. He's going to be getting some of the minutes here, which means Laverne might be down on minutes just slightly. Between the two of them. Hezonja's getting a decent amount of minutes here. It's not bad. David Lee, give him 16. Oh, Hezonja's got 24 minutes a game. I don't know how I'm failing that. I'm really hoping this team's not. Oh, actually, we're negative now. We need to think of something. We need to start setting up a little bit. We're in 7th seed, but, you know, we need to start making a push. We're going to simulate here. Wow, we're losing games. Definitely losing games. Yeah, I'd like to be able to make the playoffs this year. Aaron Gordon has suffered a broken nose. Adjust rotations. Sorry, dude. You're going to have to, you know, take a back seat here. Vucevic, going to give you some minutes. Give him 32. Joakim Noah can get a few more. Laverne, you're getting a few more here. Actually, that might be bad to have three centers sharing 30 minutes a game. Might not work, but we'll give it a few shots and see what happens. And then Hezonja off the bench is going to have 30 minutes a game. This is a wacky lineup, trust me. This is not the best that I've ever done by any means, but we're going to try it. Three centers getting 30 minutes, kind of crazy, not going to lie. We lost this game pretty badly. We're going to sim through this game, hopefully. We lost by a lot. Sim game. I can't even see here. Hezonja's getting over 24 minutes. I don't know what to tell you. But we won this game, so... And this is a kind of a weak schedule within these two games. Maybe we can win... we lost. Horribly. What's it looking like here? Vucevic. We need to change this. We need to change this up. Evan Fournier is cool. So... maybe it's time to put in Hezonja for a little while. Yeah, start Hezonja up. Give him some more minutes. We're gonna kind of cut loose some of these. We'll give him 24. DJ Augustine. And then we'll try this lineup. Just kind of, squiggling around. We're not doing good. We're definitely not doing good. Our three centers are our leading scorers, and Oladipo's not doing what he should be. We're getting... Okay, you know what? We're going to kind of falling apart here. Not what I would like to see out of this team. Fournier. Actually, in fact, I'm going to move Fournier to an edit player. You're gonna be small forward. Oh god, his hair looks awful in this. His hair looks awful. Vitals. Yeah, we're getting up on 25 minutes here. I don't want to waste too much time. Small forward. Backup shooting guard. This should help him just a tad bit. We'll see what happens. Our record's kind of slipping here. Center date. We won one of them. Can we win the second one? Whew. Which needs the most work? So this is a fail situation. That's fine. I didn't fail him. I know I didn't fail him. Look how close we are. We might not make the playoffs. I really don't think we're going to make the playoffs. We're going to sim through date. Not good. I think we're just too loaded at some positions. We don't have enough spacing here. It's not looking good. We definitely don't have enough spacing. What I do think would be a good idea here is if we're gonna take a chance, remove some of the minutes here, and give some of the minutes to guys down here. Maybe a few minutes would make it up. Look how our centers are overflowed. We're gonna sim through date. Okay, we won. We lost badly. Now, he's fully recovered. We're gonna have to make some trades. Sorry to say it, but, I mean, this is not looking good for us in any situation that you look at it. It's just not going too well. I'm gonna take some of these minutes back now that Aaron Gordon is here. Yeah, we kind of crumbled apart in the end. Oh, no. That's not who I meant to give them to. Yeah, let's just have CPU tool. Let's just do that. It's, you know, I don't care. We're gonna have to get rid of him altogether. I know we're not feeling that. And I know we played over 54 games, so I don't get it. Oh, this is ridiculous. Oh my gosh. Have coach handle. I don't know why Scott Skiles was black. We won 3 straight. Man. We're slipping here. Come on, just finish off the season. Okay, never mind. Oops. Since their date. Okay, so we've won 4 straight games. We have won 4 straight games. Right before, it's kind of like real life. Have coach handle, take care of it, man. In black, Scott Skiles, just do your thing. Oh my goodness, every other day something pops up. We're trying to get this out of the way, but all right, have coach handle. I don't care what you do. Just get us a 5th straight win. No, we lost. What is this? I mean, we had to rebuild this team at some point. We looked like we were going to be good, but, yeah. Coach Handel. Really, really trying. We need to just blame the coaching staff. 28 trust for Scott Skiles is gone. Yeah, this is not looking good. Let's look at the roster though. Right before, you know, we finished. Oops, we finished with 10 seed. Not good, but the way the roster was looking in the end. Oh, okay. I was about to freak out. Oh, look at this. Injury ridden. I mean, at least we're getting the minutes across, but. Sim through date. And we won our last game of the year. But, ladies and gentlemen, season one is as expected. No playoffs. Rebuild time. This is, you know, how we're going to free up our game. Kevin Durant with his double-double. Not bad. Brandon Knight got 6th man. Anthony Davis got the defensive player, CJ McCollum. Actually, a lot less points than in real life. Executive of the year. Not me. Not at all. Did Orlando get anything? I'm not gonna bet on it. And then we'll sim through playoffs. My predictions is Golden State takes it. I don't know. Or it could be one of those fake seasons. Wait. Hornets? D-Rose? What? The Derrick Rose? What did they get in return? I got Iguodala. And Elfrid Payton. No, they had Elfrid Payton. Excuse me, sorry. So, after one season, we got some weird stuff going on. We need a sixth man on our team. We can accomplish that. We're going to do some quick stuff, and then we're going to end this episode here, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want to make this last a million. I'm allocating all the funds to this. Finals MVP goes to you. Okay. Vince Carter went to the Hall of Fame. That's kind of surprising. Draft lottery. We're going to have to watch this. We have a chance. We have a chance at number one. Are we going to get it? I don't know. I'm hoping we can get top four. Or even number three. That'd be nice. Celtics got two lottery picks. High lottery, though. Or low lottery, whatever you'd like to say. Come on, baby. Give us the good luck. We need to draft somebody nice. Hawks. Kings. KD, you're six. No, we got fifth. Like we thought we would. Who's going to have the first pick? 70. Okay, never mind. Wow, Raptors went, 76ers got first and third. That's ridiculous. Just give them the entire draft class. We're gonna draft here. We're going to have to break this team. At least, you know, not the core, but, you know, some of the other guys. It would not make sense to put it in this way. Okay. I hate that these are 30 minutes long, but they have to be. I mean, how else am I going to be able to get anything done? So, I mean, I'm looking. I am very much so looking here. And, maybe we can get something good. Maybe we can trade up for a higher pick or trade for some talent. Brandon Ingram. We can draft him. Why not? Screw it. Unless we can get something, like, better, obviously, but, I don't think we'll get better, most likely. What? Okay, we're hoping here. Let's hope that I would rather just get some talent, or, you know, jump up a higher pick, trade some players away. We just have too much guys that have some certain things, and they pick Dragon Bender, whatever his name is. Okay. Ben Simmons is in this, I believe. He has to be. Come on. The second pick in the 2016 draft goes to... they got Ben Simmons. The Toronto Raptors. Well, at this point, I kind of assume that it's pretty much over. Brandon Ingram. Oh, well, they drafted Brandon Ingram. Oh. I want to trade my pick. I want to trade it away. Are these the only guys on their contract right now? No. No way. What can we get for this? 14th and 8th. Can we get Justice Winslow? Kemba! Freaking walk. Oh, but we have to get rid of Fournier. I don't want to do that. None of these are looking too promising. Derrick Rose, really? Not that I want to trade him. Yeah, this is a 36-minute long video. We gotta get a move on. We're gonna finish right after this. Buddy Hield. Now all the good names are pretty much done for. That leaves us with, like... Yeah, we'll review the next... Let's review them. Are they the same ones? I'm kind of hoping they're not. Derrick Rose. This gets rid of Evan Fournier, though. And Kemba Walker would not be traded. He had a breakout season. I mean, if Derrick Rose is traded, Derrick Rose is traded. That doesn't make any sense to us. He's got a giant contract. Jaylen Brown. Alright, let's do prospect. Chris Dunn. We could do something for us. Where is this guy? Brown. What? Why would I want to pick somebody up like this? Oh, well, let's get him. Okay. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have picked up a player here. We're gonna try and do some stuff. Hopefully, come back. When I come back, we'll have started a new season. Maybe made a bunch of things happen. Thanks so much for watching. Without further ado, stay classy, ladies and gentlemen. Peace out.